Mes chers amis,
my dear friends, the Word is the most complete manifestation of the human soul. Through it, this spiritual and intangible being enclosed in the body as in a prison of flesh is revealed to the outside. Through it, man makes known what he thinks, what he desires, what he likes or dislikes, and imposes his will. Today, my dear friends, in this month of June consecrated to the Sacred Heart of our Lord, we will hear the most serious, the most eloquent word that has ever fallen on earth, the word of a God attached to a cross. The word of our Savior, who, as he is about to die, addresses to us like the testament of his divine wills, while from the top of his cross, his arms stretched out between heaven and earth, he offered himself to his Father as the victim in atonement for the sins of the world, his mouth parted 7 times to let out his last cries of forgiveness and ardent supplication. My friends, the first word of Jesus crucified was a word of forgiveness. The second is a promise of consoling immortality. Beside the Redeemer's cross were 2 others on which were attached 2 guilty men, but with very different feelings. One is blaspheming, while the other prays and repents. These 2 men, my friends, perfectly represent the human race in its secular existence and in the hands of each one of its members. Among them are those who blaspheme, live in sin, and die unrepentant, in the rage of despair. There are others who, after having sinned, regret their faults, pray, and die in peace of soul. But this death, whatever it is not the end of our destiny. It is not annihilation. There is another life beyond the tomb. Jesus Christ, in the course of his evangelical mission, unceasingly proclaimed the certainty of the future life. All ancients and modern people have believed, and still believe, in the existence of the hereafter. However, my friends, this immortal life of the soul cannot be the same for everyone. This is easily understood. In his unalterable righteousness, God must treat each one according to his merits. In the great day of his judgment, he will reject the slanderers, the traitors, the proud, the renegades, the hateful and cruel hearts, all those who will have disobeyed his law and refused to atone for their revolt by a sincere repentance. He will say to them, "Depart from me, go to the eternal fires." But on the contrary, he will welcome with a smile of infinite goodness all those who with a contrite heart have returned to him through penance and prayer. He will crown with an immortal glory those who bless his name, they who have loved and helped their brothers, and he will tell them, "Come, my elect, enter into the everlasting joy of thy Lord." At this judgment, my friends, it will be as it was on Calvary during the agony of Jesus Christ. Hell on the one hand and heaven on the other side. On one side, the roars of the forsaken, on the other side, the chosen ones rejoicing. On the one hand, death, on the other hand, life and life eternal. Today, you will be with me in paradise. My friends, let us ask Mary Immaculate, the Virgin of Sorrows, to pray a great deal for all of us, for our eternal salvation, so that we may be made worthy of this blessed immortality, for we shall obtain it through regret for the faults committed and the desire to do better. And when the liberating scythe of death comes to strike us, stretched out on our bed of agony, as the merciful Jesus did to the good thief on his gallows, He will not fail to cause our souls to hear this consoling promise, "Today you will be with me in paradise." This is why we invoke our Heavenly Mother, she who constantly intercedes for us, and we tell her with all our hearts, "Mother, with the sorrowful and immaculate heart, save us." And may the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit descend upon all of you and abide with you forevermore. Amen.
Thank you.